the case of a special court judge who died of a heart attack officially in December of 2014. Questions, though, are being raised over whether the death was natural or not. Do you believe that given the sensitivity of the matter, that fact that political figures are being drawn into it, Congress is raising questions, there's an SIT demand being made, should such matters be viewed through a political lens or not, Pinky Anand, or should it be purely judicial? You seem to suggest that when things are inconvenient, then aspersions are cast on judges.
Absolutely. What have we come to actually? You have a separation of powers. It is high time that we learn to keep to those lines, and there's a reason. You have the judiciary deciding a matter based upon law, not upon sensitivities of case. So whether a politician is involved, a cricketer is involved, an actress is involved, it doesn't mean that it becomes sensitive. Therefore, it requires a different lens. The case has to be viewed from the perspective of what is presented before the court, and what do you have in this case? You have the family members who do not want to pursue this litigation, who say there's nothing suspicious of foul play. You have district court judges' reports, you have the high court judges' reports, and nonetheless, what is being spoken about today and what is being converted or attempted to be converted is a political platform in a judicial forum. I think we better stop that exercise, because otherwise all the lines will be drawn and we'll be left with no institution with its credibility intact.
Is the judiciary being effectively politicized, Indira Jaising? Is that what, it's not about corruption as much as the judiciary being politically split wide open?
Right. Let me tell you, if at all the judiciary is politicized, it can only happen at the stage of making appointments, okay? It depends on who you're inducting into the judiciary. If at the source, you are going to appoint people who agree with you, or your politics, or your right-wing politics, yes, then the judiciary is politicized. And that is the issue, I think, for me, which is very, very important. Today, we have the collegium which has recommended the appointment of Judge Joseph from Uttaranchal. Why is the government sitting on it? More than 6 months have passed since the recommendation went, and the law of the land is that a person recommended by the Supreme Court, including this Chief Justice, made the recommendation. So it's nothing personal about it. Yet the appointment is not being made. So what is that if not a corruption of the judiciary at the source level?
You're saying the executive wants convenient judges who fit in with a political ideology.
I'm saying...
Are you today saying that that only started in 2014?
No, I that's not my case. I'm not saying it only started in 2014. I have routinely said in an article which I wrote, which you may have read, called Supreme Court is sitting on a volcano, a live volcano. And that's why I disagree with what Pinky said, that all is well. There is an apparent calm in the Supreme Court. There's none. Every time I enter the courtroom, my heart is in my mouth, wondering now, which side of the fence is this judge on? It is a volcano, no less than that. And just
every time you enter the court, the judges are very scared of you.
Oh, well, that's another story.
These judges have been there, Indira, for a long time. So we can't say that at this point of time you're entering, suddenly you have this issue of having sensitivity towards X judge or Y judge. None of the judges before you are appearing are recent appointees in any event.
But Rajdeep, more importantly, let's get back to the issues that you raised. Is the judiciary in the dock? I think the judiciary is in the dock of the Janta Ki Adalat. And I think it's for the people of this country to wake up, take note of the fact, okay, it's not an Indira Jaising or a Pinky Anand whose views are important, or Rajdeep. Four sitting judges of the Supreme Court. These are not NGOs, okay? These are not right-wing or left-wing. These are people appointed through due process of law. They felt compelled. Listen to their words. They said democracy is in danger. Listen to their words. They said, if we don't speak today, we will have to forever hold our peace. Listen to their words. They said, we don't want to be told 20 years down the line that we have sold our souls. But to answer your precise question, is it happening only in 2014? No. It has been happening for a long time. But it's time all of us called a halt to this.